Most people in America have the opportunities of the magnificent stay to be in jail, especially if you have a court female officer, meaning the judge is female, who barely likes to take a vacation, who might be away for a day, which means her court cases then get passed to another magnificent judge who might be in his robe like he is in a Belushi's movie, and that he's probably got shorts on, you hope, underneath there, but you can see his bare legs coming down underneath his robe and his shoes sticking out there. The lawyer of that company might have said, oh, that's your professional name? Well, we're just going to put that on everything. Say, no, that's not my legal name. My legal name is something different than my professional name, which is my lawful right to have, to the protection of my life from the people who have been bastardizing and bashing my life. But he didn't care. He was in a group of people and basically telling all of us who were there and accused of what the rules were there. Then he'd call us out individually and basically take our situations publicly, which was sort of humiliating and embarrassing. But he still fucked up there. Then the next time she took a vacation, I was shoved in front of some religious writer who just fucked my life entirely. But then when I got to be in front of her, thank God she was back in a way, because she was so marvelous she couldn't keep up with her mouth. I just sat there and my intelligence go, wow, did you realize that you just said that? Did you realize you just violated human law, human rights law? Did you realize you just violated civil law? Did you realize that what you said was you didn't give a shit about my governance, not all that? You didn't actually care whether or not my lawyer did the job right at all. Wow. Who the fuck hired you in the state of Indiana? But by the time it was over with, God had presented with me when I was getting on the bus that I walked to that evening, literally telling me that I was going to end up staying in jail. He told me in advance of that actual court case, they've already decided to place you in jail, that that court woman and my lawyer, who was supposed to be protecting my rights, had already decided to place me in jail because of the abuses of law enforcement who had been stalking me, impeding me, interfering with my right to do what I needed to do, because that female judge, in her infinite wisdom, thought I should be medicated for something I don't have. Now, that is a liar in America. That judge has no medical training. That judge has no mental health training. That judge has no certification in any fucking thing she wanted me to get checked on by the Indiana state that was run by Pence, who basically hires liars in that mental health network. And openly, families are supposedly supported. I wasn't even allowed to know who was accusing me at that point and who was telling that I needed to still do this, and I kept getting told by my inexperienced, not even licensed lawyer that she couldn't tell me who was the alleged family representative of me. What an abuse of power. I just sat there and laughed my ass off because I'm like, okay, I could submit to this process. And while I was in jail, I did several things to keep myself busy. I wrote letters to the ministries that were given to me on a list by a Hispanic minister who was the only one who responded to me, who had apparently been a volunteer in the jail up to the point where she finally got hired, which was an abuse of her life, an abuse of her strife, but there was plenty of Hispanics there who needed to speak Spanish, so that's why they helped her and hired her. But openly, she gave me a list of ministries that supposedly sent reading materials to the jail mates. And what I did was do a mathematical and marketing study of who responded to me. But I had to entrust my mail that I was writing on my dime and my time and my paper that I bought there and my little $10 that I would get occasionally from my mother to be okay there, to have extra food if I needed it through the asinine behavior of my siblings set, was basically I wrote to these ministries and I encouraged those ministries to send me some books, but also the others in the jail some books. And I did some statistical analysis of how many letters went out and how many got positive responses, how many got negative responses. And openly, it was sort of interesting that the ministries, many of them, gave a negative response. But the one that helped me the most, the one that did the most while I was still there, and I have no clue of what came after me after I left, was Derek Prince Ministries. And they offer some of the greatest old-fashioned works on the Lord that's available today. And God bless that man. He adopted 8 girls with his second wife after his first wife died. How marvelous for the world. How incredible of a man to put up with that much fucking emotional testosterone in his household, let alone to remain a man of God in this world. But some of his books on Satan were amazing because what he talked about, which I loved in the definitions he wrote about, is how Satan is that aggressor, that human being that allows the evilness of his mind to stand in front of the Lord God of all time.